Now, the next film that we made together with Zorba, there was an interval of 3 years that time, between 61 and 64. In that interval, he made one more film with Ellie Lambetti in Italy. Ellie Lambetti, meantime, had married a guy called Frederick Wakeman, who is an author. I think that's correct, Frederick Wakeman, yes. And they had a project from a book of his, the title which I forget, and it was going to be made in Italy. In fact, it was made in Italy, and once again we ran into the union problem. The Italian said, yes, you can make the film in Italy and all the rest, but you have to use an Italian cameraman. So Michael used an Italian cameraman, and that's why there was a three-year gap between Electra and Zorba. Now, Zorba was a favorite book of Kate's. And it was Kate, actually, who suggested to Quinn that he film Zorba. And it was also Kate's suggestion that he takes Anthony Quinn, because it was quickly apparent, or it was generally agreed, that there was no Greek actor that was capable of playing that part for an international audience, that's to say in English, because they didn't want to do it in Greek with subtitles. That wouldn't have been the right thing to do in a case like that. So he agreed readily that Quinn would be a suitable actor to play that part, and he went off to Hollywood and he signed him as he went off to Athens to talk to the widow of Kazantzakis and to get the rights to make the film, none of which was any problem. Also, Quinn seemed to have agreed quite readily. So the female role female principal role of Madame Hortense was scheduled to be Simone Signoret. And they all arrived, and we started, and within about a week of beginning the shooting, it was obvious that Simone couldn't play a woman that weak or that vulnerable. She just couldn't be that vulnerable. She was too strong a personality. And there was a sort of mutual recognition of this fact, and she bowed out very gracefully. And Cacoyannis went off to Paris. The shooting was interrupted for 2 or 3 days, not very long. And Cacoyannis went off to Paris, and he found Lila Kedrova, and he brought her back. And Lila Kedrova, at that point, didn't speak a word of English. She spoke only Russian and French. And she learned her part in the space of 24 hours. Within 24 or 36 hours of her arrival, we were filming. With the night scene outside her house where she dances and plays a quite a large scene, well, she learned that by rote within a few hours of arrival virtually and played that scene and played it all beautifully and won the Oscar for it. Anthony Quinn was another thing. He's a Hollywood star, so I wasn't surprised when there were certain initial problems. In fact, he came to us and he said, "Nah, I'm only good in my first take, so it's up to you technical people to get it all ready, to prepare it all, and then I come and I do my take and that's it." And Cacoyannis didn't say a word, but it was me who said something. I said, "Yeah, Mr. Quinn, but we don't work that way here." And he looked at me, so nobody's ever said that to him before. They always said, "Yes, Mr. Quinn, of course, we will do what we need." So I said, "We technicians also have the right to make mistakes and to prepare. We may need a retake. We'll do our best, of course."